Hello all, welcome back. This is Dr. O, and in this video we're going to talk about the auditory ossicles. Now the word ossicle just means little bones, and we have a whole video here to talk about the tiniest bones in your body. As well as being the smallest bones in the body, they're actually the first ones to ossify during development. So any newborn baby has almost entirely mature auditory ossicles. Whereas many of our bones, like the long bones of our limbs, don't fully ossify or become mature until we're 25 years old. So they're pretty cool little bones. So the learning objectives here are, what are those middle ear ossicles, and how do the middle ear ossicles function in hearing? You'll remember the auditory ossicles from our discussion of the middle ear. Now, all three of these bones are found within the petrous part of the temporal bone, and they articulate with one another to lead from the tympanic membrane to the oval window. This will project forward the sound that was collected by the external ear through vibrations between these bones. You'll note as well that the tympanic membrane is a lot larger than the oval window is over here. So by the time that the vibrations get to the stapes will be having about 10 times the strength of vibration than we see at the tympanic membrane. Now let's talk through these ossicles from the tympanic membrane over to the oval window. Our first is the malleus. I have two listed here, as we have one on either side. The malleus is a hammer. That's what it refers to. We can see this portion right here is referred to as its handle, and you can imagine that being the part that you would try to hammer a nail into the wall with, potentially. This is the largest of the bones, and we can see its attachment there at the tympanic membrane. The incus is the second, and it is an anvil shape, and this is found between the two ossicles and is intermediate in size. The smallest of the ossicles is called the stapes, and it's the smallest bone in our body as well. So this is a stirrup shape, as you see right here, and it sits in the oval window. So let's take a look at how these are related to one another in 3D space. And you'll note that everywhere they come together is at a synovial joint. So there are synovial joints connecting each of the three ossicles. Malleus to incus, and then incus to stapes. So here we see our stapes heading toward the medial wall. There's the foot plate there. Here's the malleus and its handle there, and the intermediate incus between the two. And just represented here, just so you're aware of it, but we'll keep bringing it up, that is the chorda tympani nerve. And this in green is the tympanic membrane. All right, so let's start here with our malleus. So this is a hammer shape. So the parts of it, the hammer portion, is the head. And the head is what we'll articulate with incus. You can kind of see incus posteriorly here. We also see where they come together around there and around here from this different view. Below the head is a narrowing, and anytime you have a head with a narrowing, that structure is called the neck. Now the manubrium is the handle, or the portion that is pushed up or articulating directly with that tympanic membrane. So the manubrium also serves as the attachment point for the tensor tympani muscle, which can slow the vibrations of the malleus and the tympanic membrane. And we also see this is where we find the chorda tympani will pass over the malleus at the manubrium. Now let's move on to incus. Here we can see incus. It's actually a body, and then two limbs, one here and one here. The body is what will articulate with malleus. So there's a facet there, or a little indentation for where incus articulates with malleus, as we can see here. on the right. Then we see the shorter and kind of more blunt and short limb here, and then the long limb running right around here. And we'll note in this image over on the right, the long limb of the incus runs parallel to the malleus, and specifically the manubrium of the malleus. At the base or the end of the long limb is what we call the lenticular process. Now the lenticular process, you see sort of a little bend, and that will then articulate with the stapes. So here you can see that articulation and there as well. This is sort of a feature of the long limb. And you'll note as well, kind of the chorda tympani doesn't have as close of a relationship with the incus, but you do see it pass between the incus and the tympanic membrane before then passing over the manubrium of the malleus. Our final bone here is the stapes. So here is that stirrup shape in purple. And we're looking actually from a superior view. So we're standing above the middle ear, looking down. Here's the cochlea, the vestibule. Here's the tympanic membrane, and you can kind of see the malleus and the incus ghosted out here. All right. So let's start with the stapes at the head. So the head of the stapes is right here, and that is what articulates with that lenticular process of the incus. You can see those articulations along the way. Then we see a bit of a narrowing, and the narrowing, the neck, is where the stapedius muscle will come to articulate. So the stapedius muscle can also kind of slow down the vibrations of the stapes and then the oval window. From the head and the neck, we then lead to two legs or limbs, but a crus is the kind of the word for a leg. So we have an anterior one and a posterior one, kind of these two split of the stirrup shape. And finally, we get to the base of the stapes, which is the foot plate, and that sits in the oval window, which then leads toward the vestibule. All right, so let's assess ourselves here, and I want you to answer this question. Which part of the malleus attaches to the tympanic membrane and is the attachment point for tensor tympani muscle? Is it the head, the manubrium, or the neck? So choose your answer, and then we'll talk about it. So remember our first, over here in the image, our first ossicle is the malleus. Its head is this portion here, followed by the neck, and then this portion that articulates with the tympanic membrane or comes in contact with it is the manubrium. So the correct answer here is the manubrium. So the muscle that attaches to stapes does so where? Do you remember? So that muscle will project from the posterior wall toward the stapes, and that attaches to the neck, and that's the stapedius muscle. Awesome. Great job. That's everything for this video. Thank you for joining me, and please let me know if you have any questions at all.